Welcome to Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines 10.5. And these are the bonus quests. And by bonus quest, I mean these are the quests that give you bonus XP. So I will get, with these three quests, I will get an additional 3 XP by saving them to this point in the game. So, yeah, how to do this one? Well, this one you have to go back and forth between the two killers, and you don't want to like take an option to get out of this quest too soon. It's at least, I think it's 3 times, but let's go ahead and count it. We come to this guy, this is our first time coming up to him, and he tells us to go kill the other old man, and that's great. We want to go talk to Lou. The dialogue here is absolutely great. It's some of the funniest dialogue in the game. Oh, and there's a watch on the floor here, so we'll pick up the watch. And he comes out, and when he comes out, we talk to him. Yeah, I pretty much just agree with these guys, carry on the conversation. Again, the dialogue is hilarious. These two are very funny. Some of the just great lines. And the thing to keep in mind is these are both killers and they're both liars. So everything they say about the other guy is probably a lie, but maybe not. You don't know, but you're a vampire, so you don't really care anyway. So, yeah. There are options to end the conversation by getting them to not kill each other. Or you can tell them to go ahead and kill each other, then you won't get the max amount of XP. We want the 7 experience points for this quest. You can also just kill one of them, I think. But then I think you only get 3 or 4. Well, if you get 3, then you would get 4. So, yeah, that's no good. We want the 7 experience points. Okay, now that's the first round. Now we come back, this is the second round. And you just want to keep the conversation going, and okay. See, if you go with, can't you reconcile now, this will not turn out well. You want to keep this going. Now we've gone to him 3 times. Okay, we've come back to him 3 times. Lou offered me 40%, so we're up to 40%. Word like poison to brain. That's great. He offered me 50%. Doggy kisser, seller of sister underwear. His insults are so good. Okay, now we get an opportunity to persuade, and we're going to take that. So make peace. Great. Now we go back to Liu Fang one more time. See, that was pretty easy. It's just like a couple of rounds, make peace, but you don't want to do it too early. So, yeah, big Liu splat all over. Oh, there's another line here, giving alcohol to Liu is like giving alcohol to Liu. You know, it's just hilarious. Yeah, big Liu stain all over Red Dragon. That's great. Absolutely great. Experience 7, that is even better. So we now have 7 experience points. And yeah, I basically played from here to the end of the game in like a straight shot. And I gotta tell you, this character is gonna be insanely powerful, much more powerful than I thought. So, yeah, stay tuned. This character just strolls through most of the game from this point on. We have 3 in fortitude, 3 in presence. All the other attributes and abilities are very powerful, and I'm actually going to raise a couple of them too. And you're just not even going to believe. I'm looking at maybe 2 points at more points in dominate might be possible, because at this point I'm thinking of only going to 4 in presence and fortitude. You're going to be surprised what this character is able to have. I do, in fact, put a second point in dominate, but I never get it to work properly. It never does anything for me. I put a second point in dominate because I have a lot of points. I have a lot more points than I think I'm going to have. And yeah. Now I'm looking at lockpicking and sneaking. Lockpicking of 9, sneaking of 8, hacking of 11. It's crazy. Inspection of 7, research of 9. Yeah, just. And we're going to get stronger, believe it or not. We're going to get stronger, much stronger. I end up having a lot more points than I think. And I'm. Yeah, I think I put up another point into. Even into sneaking. So. Hey, another dance floor that I don't need. Just checking to see if there's anything sparkly. Okay, this is the Ash quest. So the gangster quest gave us 7. Doing the Ash quest, fighting, you get $500 instead of 250, but I've already determined that I am fine for cash, and I'm just like I'm sprinting through the game at this point, really. And so we're just going to do the we're going to get the same XP for doing the quest by doing it this way, which is just the persuasion check. And but we're only going to get $250, so I lose 250 here. But we have, I can't stress this enough, plenty of money. Plenty of cash, and cash is not going to be a problem. So 5 in haggling or in haggle is all you need. So yeah, we're going to persuade this guy. He looks like Ash, but he doesn't have the voice. Completely different voice actor. $250 instead of 500, and we got 4. Now, normally this is worth 3 experience points, but because of the enchanted item, we got 4. So, yeah, that's why these are the bonus quests. And the hunter kills an innocent man. And we have 17 experience that we need to play. Yeah, 44. Yeah, we have lots of money. And we could dance a little bit. Now I'm not going to dance for 5 minutes. I'm just going to dance for like 1 minute to the really cool music, actually 15 or 20 seconds, and then leave. We don't need a humanity, we're fine. 9 humanity is great. Okay, I'm just fast tracking through this dialogue. We want to go over here and talk to her, and this is worth some XP. Okay, 2 XP, that's great. We're not going to side with the Hangyokai. We're going to kill this guy. Now, at this point, you can side with him and kill her. And I forget how much money he gives. I don't need cash, so it's not a big deal. I'm just concerned about the XP. So, more cash is always better, but I'm perfectly happy. I kind of would like to have her show up when I go take on Ming, just because I like to have her there. And she does show up, and it's nice to have her show up. I think she's invincible. I think she's unkillable. It's just kind of nice to fight with her. Side by side against, well, she only goes a short distance into the area where all of Ming's soldiers are, but still, it's kind of neat. I kind of like when you have a companion. Okay, I sped up everything before this, but the fight is not going to be sped up. The fight is going to be at normal speed. So while it's going through the animation, I can't equip the weapon. That's a weird thing about the game is, it disarms you and then you have to equip up. I don't know what the purpose of that is. I don't know. So presence, he isn't really hitting me with anything. For the little bit of blood it takes, it costs for fortitude. But he just hit me with a rock and it did, as you can see, zero damage. Yeah, those claws, however, do some damage. But you know what else does damage? The Steyr AUG does damage. So, yeah. I could have had Fortitude up. So, nice fighting with you, and I look forward to seeing you very shortly. Actually, in a couple of hours, as it turns out, because a couple of hours after this, in real life, I was killing Ming Zhao, so. Yeah, don't forget to pick up the $200, and yeah, there we go. Yeah, go sharpen up that sword because you're going to need it very shortly. A couple of hours from now. So, yeah, we're ready to go. Our fourth point into either presence or fortitude, and we are in very, very good shape right now. Lots of XP to play. Our character sheet is looking great. Yeah, very powerful and about to get even more powerful. Stay tuned. I will see you in the next episode. Thanks for watching.